Well, as has been mentioned in the past, almost every aspect of business is being examined to see what impact artificial intelligence can have to improve operations. Today, we take a look at it from the customer service perspective. Pleasure to be joined by Christian Terwiesch, who's a professor of operations, information, and decisions here at the Wharton School. Christian, great to talk to you again. How are you, sir?
Hey, always glad to be on your show.
Thank you, sir. Look, this is obviously an interesting topic, especially when you think about the fact that customer service has been one of these elements of business that in many cases has been ridiculed by the public. But now we're talking about it as a way to, that maybe we can improve it. So when you think about the connection between AI and customer service, what first comes to mind?
I think the big challenge is that, I mean, everybody else on the consumer basis is familiar with that we have many disappointments in the customer service experiences that we have. Think about interacting with your airline, your insurance, your bank. Most of us have horror stories of kind of bad customer support. And let's acknowledge it, it's pretty damn hard because it's a very tedious, a very labor-intense piece of work that the service provider has to provide on demand, on the time and in synchronization with the needs of the customer. So it's nothing that you can do like on an assembly line. So it's really hard work. And I think many companies have turned to AI and have arguably somewhat naively believed that this problem is going to go away because of AI. And I think we've seen some things work, but many things that do not.
So for companies, is the expectation then the customer service, or is it the cost savings they may have, or is it a combination of both?
That goes to the heart of the problem, right? So you think in general in strategy and operations, we like to think about a cost trade-off, a cost-quality trade-off, right? So in one dimension, you can imagine the efficiency is a productivity as measured in dollars per episode. And on the other dimension, you think about some version of customer delight, willingness to pay, customer utility. And there's a trade-off, right? I mean, I can give you an amazing service if money doesn't matter. I can give you a glass of champagne. I can give you a back massage. And I make you the happiest customer ever, but it's going to be bloody expensive. Or I say, like, hell, you're going to wait an hour long on the call center, on the call line. I'm going to give you a crappy service with somebody who barely speaks English. So there's this trade-off. And the hope is that we can push this trade-off curve outwards and give you better service at lower cost. The empirical pattern that I've seen most companies do is when they've shifted that frontier, they hope the AI will give them lower cost. So they're solving for lower cost as opposed to better customer service.
But don't companies still want to have a human component involved in customer service somewhere along the line? They just can't, you know, go 100% AI.
Well, so that is a challenge. And I think for two reasons. So one is, what do you want as a company? There's a certain argument that you say, like, there's a human touch. I mean, again, think about maybe a real estate agent, maybe think about a cardiologist. You kind of want to talk to a human being just to be safe because the stakes are really high. The second piece is independent of what do we want as a company, what do we have to do? And I think we're waking up to the reality that ChatGPT and other tools are really good of getting us 80% of the way, but not to 100%. And so most people then kind of wave their hands at some point and say, like, whoa, we need a human in the loop. And that is when it gets expensive, right? That human in the loop is costing a lot of money, and the workflow is even more complicated than before.
But the expectation of the consumer in many cases these days, and it's been talked about a lot by retailers, is that they need to make sure that the experience for their consumer is as good as possible, even if they have the AI, so that customer will continue to come back time and time again. They don't want to lose them because of a bad experience.
Absolutely, right? I think the customer expectations are high, and they're only getting higher. And at the same time, many customer support centers are struggling with the high cost and the high customer's expectations. And again, because you, in most settings, need to keep some form of a human in the loop, we're not at zero marginal cost. And so I see a lot of companies struggling with how do we educate the customers that they can do self-service without the human in the loop. That's when we make the big money. But again, that requires training or educating our customer beyond just kind of having them call up ChatGPT.
One of the things I saw written about when you talk about the connection between AI and customer service is the potential to improve the language barrier for consumers, with AI being able to speak to consumers in the language of in their own language and not have to have that misconnection because somebody can't speak Spanish or German or French or whatever it might be.
Well, you shouldn't ask the person who speaks with a German accent here.
Right.
I think there's language barrier, and indeed, I think that is a good point. I think the more important point I want to double-click on is the eloquency, the persuasiveness of ChatGPT. We've seen in study after study, it is better arguing, it's more empathetic, it's more lovely to talk with an AI person than with a human being. And that's scary and tells us a lot about human beings. But again, it comes out in study after study that AI is really sweet and persuasive. And I think that makes even more difference than the language capability.
So then I'll leave you on this. What do you think then is the longer term impact of AI in customer service?
I think for the near future, we're going to have some form of a hybrid workflow where we have a human who is augmented through some ChatGPT type of technology. It's a hybrid where, again, I might be able to get a little bit more productivity out of the agent by helping the agent through text prompts in the screen and the interview, by automating some follow-up chat messages. But hopefully we can get to a point where in 5 or 10 years, a lot of the tasks that still require a human in the loop would be fully automated. But I don't think we're there yet.
Christian, great to talk to you. And thank you again for your insight, sir.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you. Christian Terwiesch, who is Professor of Operations, Information, and Decisions here at the Wharton School.